tell us a little bit about yourself, who you are, and what you do.
Let me just start by saying I'm Anthony Fuller. I'm a broadcast journalist based in Nairobi, and I've been a radio journalist for the last 8 years. From the basics of being a news reporter, news editor, programs producer, presenter, to heading the national radio, KBC. That was my last assignment 2 weeks ago. If I move over to Internews Network. So part of the stuff that I like doing is training journalists in all aspects. I'm a specialist in child and human rights, peace and security, and conflict reporting. And apart from that, I've been able to work for organizations such as Oxfam Group. I've also been consulting for Internews before they took me out. And I've spread myself thin across the continent. Yes.
And Internews, what do you do? What does
Internews is a media development organization. The parent Internews is based in USA, but what we have in Kenya is an affiliate, so we call it Internews Network Kenya. What Internews does is to train journalists. When they came to Kenya, they began beneficial of the first training sessions in health reporting. So that's health in terms of HIV and AIDS. But after that, they decided to expand the scope because they began with broadcast journalists, training them in health and HIV and AIDS. Then they moved into science. Then from that point, they extend the scope to include print journalists as well. We are also now doing online. We're also doing TV. So we train journalists in sensitive reporting, what has to do with HIV and AIDS, what has to do with peace, what has to do with conflicts, governance. And this means that we have to look for everybody across the country. So for media, not only media houses, journalists, we also look at media managers. We also work closely with civil society organizations, trying to help them to interact with the media, because at times they come to us saying that we got these nice stories that are not covered well in the media. What do we do? So part of the work of the intern is also to share with the civil society what needs to be done if you want to be covered, but mostly how do you frame your stories so that they become interesting.
And then this kind of gathering, in which way do you see it assisting you?
This is a very important gathering, and I like the diversity that we have here and the kind of stuff that people do. Given that now we are shifting focus at Internews to try to help community radio stations in the country.
But I think
they've been growing, and the media in Kenya is growing big and vibrant. The challenge has always been that media lacks substance, especially the electronic kind where I'm a specialist. When you come to listen to our radio stations, the stories do not add up to much. We just go for the obvious, the daily news stories, but we do not go and interrogate issues. Look at the depth. So part of what Internews has been doing as we train the journalists is to help them go that extra mile and get a good story that actually highlights the aspirations. So starting January, we shall be focusing on community media. Community media in Kenya face various challenges. Key among them will be funding. So if they're not well funded, they're not able to attract the right journalists. So if you're unable to attract the right journalists, that means that the kind of information you pass out is in the hands of inexperienced people who've never been trained. So from station management to content development to news gathering, there are big gaps. And we are coming from the post-election violence that happened in 2007. And part of that was contributed by poor reporting, poor journalism, because politicians were able to use the media to advance their agenda, and nobody was there to moderate that. So you're trying to address that by getting journalists, actually training a critical pool that can be sensitive in how you address issues to do with our ethnic diversity, how you address issues to do with politics and governance, okay? The depth that you go in, but most importantly, do it professionally. So we work with the mainstream media, we train journalists across the country in various radio stations. The work is big, enormous, but then we discover that community media is growing, but nobody is giving it a special attention that it deserves. Yet community media commands a very big listenership rate in the country. So you can't go wrong with community media. You need to engage, you need to professionalize it, you need to support. That's now what Internews is focusing on. Yes. Yeah.